Record. Ok. So, en español, nosotros conjugamos, conjugate the verbs, ok. So, para conjugar los verbos terminados en AR, AR, por ejemplo, el verbo bailar. El verbo bailar, that you see on the screen, bailar, to dance. Mm-hmm. We have to conjugate it, right? And get the different conjugations. So, el verbo bailar, I'm going to conjugate it and I will say, el verbo bailar, the ending is AR, right? So, what I'm going to do is to drop the AR part and I will keep bail, right? And I will add the different endings that I have here. I got the ending O, A, R, A, A, Amos, I, N, An. So I will say, yo, bail, tu, bail, el, bail, nosotros, nosotros, bail, ellos, bail, en vosotros, no, en vosotros, ellos, ok, nosotros, vosotros, y ellos, ok, so, ok, you have to do this for every single verb in Spanish, ok, so, el verbo bailar, that's an AR verb, so I'm gonna drop the AR part, and I'm gonna keep the stem, bail, so I will say, yo bail, and then I have to start adding the endings, right? So we have different endings. So I will say yo bailo, right? So I'm gonna add the ending O. Tú bailas.
Yeah.
Okay, tú bailas, él baila, nosotros bailamos, vosotros bailáis, y ellos bailan, okay? So, yo bailo, tú bailas, él o ella baila, nosotros en nosotras bailamos,
vamos.
Nosotros en vosotras bailáis, ellos en ellas bailan, okay? So, the endings that you see on the PowerPoint are for yo, tú, él, on the left side, from the top to the bottom, yo, tú, él, the singular. And on the right side, from the top to the bottom, are the plural, nosotros, vosotros, ellos, okay? So this conjugation right here is the what you're gonna do for all give me a second. Do we use I? See, we use I. It's not very usual, not very common, because that's the conjugation that the people use in Spain. Like I in Chile or in Mexico, people don't use that conjugation that much, and it's for you all. So we use the ustedes or ellos. And it is also for the third person plural. And I is for vosotros, which is also the third person plural. So in some countries, like in Spain, they use more the vosotros and we use the ustedes, ellos, okay? So, and the book, they use it because the book is from Spain. So that's why. But you are not gonna hear anybody using that conjugation, this one. Actually, for me, it's very difficult to do that conjugation because I don't do it. Like, I don't use it. Never. But it's the same like ellos or ustedes. The ustedes is the formal from for ellos. It's the same. This is the same. It means you all. Okay? Entonces, vamos a practicar. El verbo. Okay, so we have here verbo bailar, right? yo bailo, tú bailas, él baila, nosotros bailamos, vosotros bailáis, ellos bailan. Okay, so I told you last class that we have so many verbs that ending with AR. In the infinitive form, like buscar is to look. So for us, the infinitive form is like in English when you say to watch, to look, to read. Okay, the infinitive form is the AR form when the verbs are not conjugated. Okay, but whenever you say I, you, he, or she, then you have to conjugate the verb. Okay, so we keep the verbs in infinitive and then we conjugate them. The infinitive form is when the verb is not conjugated. For example, when the ending is AR, bailar, buscar. So all this list right here, the verbs are not conjugated. They are in their infinitive form. So, por ejemplo, tenemos aquí el verbo buscar, the first one. Buscar is to look, okay? To search, okay? So el verbo buscar. Buscar. So we are gonna drop the AR, okay? The AR, we drop it so we get busc, right? Busc. So it will be, oops. Yo busc, right? Tú busc, él or ella busc, nosotros en nosotras, vosotros. En vosotras y ellos, ellas, or ustedes. Okay, so and then I'm gonna use another color. Okay, so yo busco, tú buscas, él o ella busca, nosotros buscamos, vosotros buscáis, ellos buscan. Okay. Okay, so nosotros. Okay, so ahí está listo. Okay, entonces el verbo buscar. Le sacamos, we drop the AR, le sacamos la finalización AR, and we're gonna say, yo busco, tú buscas, él o ella busca, nosotros buscamos, vosotros buscáis, and ellos, ellas, or ustedes buscan. Okay? Este es buscan con AL. ¿Ok? ¿Ok? ¿Sí se entiende?
Sí.
Ok. Ok, so it's the same thing that you have to do for every single verb that ending is AR. So you are going to do the same thing for all the verbs. So what you have to do is to get familiar with the ending, okay? So, por ejemplo, vamos a ver, el verbo estudiar, to study, estudiar, estudiar, estudiar. So el verbo estudiar, if I say, mis alumnos están, mis alumnos estudian, mis estudiantes estudian, my students study, en español, alumnos is for students, not for people that already graduate, okay? So, estudiar. Ustedes, or mis estudiantes, estudian. Ustedes estudian. Ellas estudian. See, it's the same conjugation because it refers to you all, okay? Ustedes is formal. Mis estudiantes, my students, estudian. Ellos or ellas estudian, okay? And I will say, yo estudio. Yo estudio. Okay? Yo estudio. Ellas estudian. And the verb is estudiar. That is the infinitive form. Okay? Do you see the difference? See?
Sí.
Okay.
Sí.
Okay. Entonces, so this is important, right? And you have to keep it in mind for asking and answering questions. Because when I ask the question, I ask to you, but you answer like I, right? Do you study? Yes, I do. Okay, so I will ask you, ¿tú estudias español? Do you study Spanish? ¿Tú estudias español? And you're gonna answer, yes, I study español, right? Spanish. Sí, yo estudio español, okay? So in the question is, ¿tú estudias español? And you answer, sí, yo estudio, okay? So next to tú, you have to have the ending AS, tú estudias. And then I'll say, yo estudio. It's another ending, okay? So you have to keep in mind the conjugations form, okay? ¿Sí se entiende? ¿Sí entienden? ¿Sí? So tell me if I'm going too fast or if you don't understand or what. I don't see your faces. I am just seeing one face, de Tomás. Es la única cara que veo. Tomás, ¿sí entiendes? ¿Sí?
Sí. Sí.
¿Sí? Okay. ¿Sí? Okay. Okay. And, well, you maybe, I'm not going to memorize that today, but at least you have to have the big picture of it. So, do you have to keep in mind the conjugation form? So, if it's yo, if it's tú, él, and then conjugate the verb, okay? Then, so we have here a big, big list of AR verbs, buscar, estudiar, cantar, okay? All these verbs, bailar, cantar, viajar, hablar, to speak, to buy, to read, to search, to walk. All of those verbs are AR verbs, okay? Okay, so entonces vamos a decir another question. ¿Tú compras? Do you buy? ¿Tú compras leche, milk? Do you buy leche? Do you buy milk? ¿Tú compras leche? That's a question. And the answer is sí, yes, yo compro leche. Okay? So you say, ¿tú compras? And you say, yes, yo compro. Okay, so the thing is here is that you need to conjugate these verbs, okay? Por ejemplo, Luis, Blank, and what are the activities on the VHL, for example, on your Vista homework? Fill in the blanks, right? We got Luis, blank, and the verb cantar, to sing. La canción. So we have Luis, blank, cantar la canción. He sings the song. Luis sings the song. So cantar, conjugated by Luis. What is Luis? It will be yo, tú, él, or nosotros.
Él.
Luis is él, right? He. So Luis canta. Luis canta la canción. Esta la escribo. Okay, Luis canta la canción. Luis es él, it's he. So you have to conjugate the verb cantar. Él canta, Luis canta. Okay? Okay, ¿cómo están? How do you feel about the conjugating these verbs? ¿Bien? ¿Sí?
Muy bien.
¿Todo bien con los AR verbs? Okay, okay, entonces, antes de empezar con... Okay, so vamos a ver estas terminaciones aquí. Y vamos a ver. Okay, tengo aquí estos ejercicios. Okay, número uno, yo, blank, cantar la canción. So, how is going to be the first one? Yo.
Canto.
Canto. Yo canto la canción. Muy bien. Segundo, mi mamá. Mi mamá mirar televisión, watch TV. Mi mamá mirar televisión.
Would it be an A on the end?
Mm-hmm. Mira, mi mamá mira, because it's she, right? Ella.
I can't pronounce it, I'm sorry.
Mi mamá mira la televisión. Okay, nosotros buscar la casa.
Buscamos.
Buscamos. Nosotros buscamos. Uy, I can't read. Buscamos. Nosotros buscamos la casa. Y Luis y María tomar el agua, the water. María, agua.
Tomé.
because it's they, ellos. Toman.
Toman.
Toman el agua. ¿Se entiende?
Sí. Sí.
Ok, entonces vamos a pasar a el verbo gustar, ok. El verbo gustar, the ending is AR, but it's different. It is the only verb that is different, ok. It's the big, big exception on the AR verbs. El verbo gustar, it is to like. Okay, like I like to drink water, I like to dance, I like watch TV. Okay, ¿qué te gusta? What do you like? Okay, so el verbo gustar es diferente. Okay, it's an exception. So we don't conjugate the verb gustar. You are not gonna do yo gusto, tú gustas, él gusta. No. Okay. With the verb gustar, we are going to use pronouns, okay? You're going to say, a mí me gusta, a ti te gusta, no yo gusto, okay? So, el verbo gustar, you don't have to conjugate it, okay? And you are going to use pronouns, okay? A mí me, that's the pronoun, gusta. You don't say yo gusta and tu gusta, or you say yo gusta, el gusta. Okay, so you're gonna say a mí me gusta. The me is the pronoun, okay? You're not gonna say yo gusta, no, 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 okay? You don't conjugate the verb gustar, okay? So you can say a mí me gusta or only me gusta, okay? What is important here is the pronoun me, okay? You can say a mí me gusta or only me gusta, okay? But do not use the yo, tú, él, no, okay? We are gonna use a mí me gusta, or a ti te gusta, or a él le gusta, okay? So we need these pronombres, estos de aquí, okay? Those, a mí me gusta bailar, a él le gusta dibujar, a nosotros nos gusta saltar, a vosotros os gusta trabajar, y a ellos les gusta estudiar. So the first one, it means I like to dance. The second one, he likes to draw. Okay? To us, a nosotros, like nos gusta saltar, to jump. Okay? So if you see here the verb bailar, dibujar, saltar, trabajar, y estudiar, every single verb that is next to gusta, to like, me gusta bailar, to dance, all these verbs right here, the ending is AR, and they are in infinitive. They are not conjugated. So every single verb that goes next to gustar, we keep that verb in infinitive. We don't conjugate the verb that goes next to gustar. Okay, so, por ejemplo, I could say, yo salto, I jump, right? Yo salto. So, the verb is saltar, right? That's the AR verb. So, here I'm going to say, yo salto. So, I have conjugated the verb saltar, to jump. Me gusta saltar. Okay, so the verb saltar, to jump. Yo salto, that's I jump. Yo salto. So I have conjugated this verb saltar with the yo person, right? So I conjugate this verb. But if I want to say I like to jump, a mí, me, I'm gonna use the pronoun, gusta saltar. And then this verb right here, I don't conjugate the verb because it's next to gustar. So anytime that I have a verb next to gustar, I don't conjugate the verb. That verb goes in infinitive, infinitivo, okay? Infinitivo, okay? And infinitivo, no conjugated, no lo conjugo, okay? So with the verb gustar, we have things. Any verb that is next to gustar, we don't conjugate the verb. With the verb gustar, we have to have pronoun. Me gusta, le gusta, nos gusta, os gusta, and les gusta. Those pronouns, you have to memorize them, okay? You have to be very familiar with the pronouns, okay? So the verb gustar is especial. So if you see, I just changed the pronoun. Me, le, nos, os, and les. But the gusta is always gusta, even though it's a mí, or to you, to us, a nosotros, a vosotros, ellos, it's always gusta. And the verb next to gusta, is it goes in infinitive. So the only thing that I have to focus on is to choose the correct pronoun. Me, or le, or nos, or os, or les. Okay? ¿Se entiende?
I have a question. Is there a te or two?
Oh, sí. I'm missing. Oh my God, I'm missing that one on the PowerPoint. I was saying it, but like, I'm. Se me perdió a ti. So I have the T, the, what is it here? A ella, a ella, a mí, a él. Oh, infinitive. Okay, so let me write the pronouns. Me, that's for I. And then te, that's for you. Le is for he or she. And vosotros, nosotros, that's for us. And this is you all. Ustedes, ellos. Ellos, you all too. Ahí está. Me faltaba el T aquí.
Hold on, can I see that again?
Ay, lo siento.
Gracias.
It should be on your book too. The book has good like boxes with verbs and things, so you can check it on. It should be on your book también. okay. So on the questions, like before we were conjugating the two verbs, on the questions would be the same thing. ¿Te gusta viajar? ¿A ti te gusta viajar? So, a ti, to you, te gusta, the pronoun te, that goes to next to gustar. And then, sí, a mí, Me gusta viajar. Okay? So remember that the pronouns are going to change depending on who is asking the question and who is answering, because you ask, do you like travel? And I say, ah, yes, I do. Okay? ¿A ti te gusta bailar? No, a mí no me gusta bailar. Okay? Ah, sorry. Yes. Okay. Okay. And yeah, the infinitive. So, a mí, yo, I, me gusta dibujar. A ella, she, le gusta dibujar. Okay. So the pronoun me here and the pronoun le. A ella le gusta desayunar, breakfast. A mí me gusta desayunar. So you see the verb gustar, it keeps the same. It doesn't change. What we are going to change is the pronoun that goes before gustar, okay? And also the verb that goes after gustar, we keep it in infinitive, okay? We don't conjugate those verbs. Okay, and then to say something you like, you use me gusta. I like, me gustan los gatos. Now, the only thing that we're gonna do with gustar is if it's plural or singular. So me gusta, gusta, or gustan. Okay, so gusta es singular, gustan es plural. And gusta es singular, obvio, singular. For example, me gusta el agua. I like the water, me gusta el agua. Gustan es plural. Plural, okay? So it will be, me gustan los gatos. Okay, cat, the kitties. Okay, so me gustan los gatos. So I know this is plural because of the article los. The article los is plural. So it's more than one cat. I like all the cats, every cat, too many cats. Okay. So this is singular, this is singular and this is plural. And I know it's plural because of the article. Okay, so it will be me gustan los gatos. So with gustar, only if it's singular or plural. Okay, but if it's plural or singular, doesn't matter, you are gonna use the pronoun. The same thing, me gusta el agua or me gustan los gatos. It will be always the pronoun me for me. If I use, I'm using I, right? So nothing changed on the sentence besides adding the N at the end if it's plural. Okay, gustan. Okay. Ah, and then so me gustan los gatos. Or me gusta hablar español. I like to speak Spanish. Okay. And these gustos, this is what I don't like, dislike, I don't like. I just have to add the no before. No me gustan. No me gusta la tarea. I don't like the homework. No me gusta estudiar. I don't like to study. A Sam, no le gustan or no le gusta. Okay, so I just add the no before the pronoun. No me gusta, no le gustan. Okay, just adding the no before the pronoun that goes before gustar. Pobrecito. Okay. Okay, don't worry. I like to see the faces, because if I'm talking now and I don't see any face of anyone, like I don't know if you're doing this or you're with your face, like, so I'm missing the faces, because that helps me to know if I'm going too fast or if it's confusing or if you understand or so. Okay, so we good? ¿Se entiende? ¿Sí?
Sí.
Sí.
¿Sí? Ok. So, move on. Ok, vamos a hacer un repaso, un review, ok? Un review, un repaso. ¿Qué hora es? Does anyone remember how to say time? ¿Qué hora es? ¿Qué hora es ahora? ¿Qué hora es?
Son las 6:17 a la tarde.
Muy bien. Son las 6:17 de la tarde. Muy bien. Bien. ¿Ok? ¿Qué hora es? Acá, the first one. This one. I am. So, son las 2:40. Son las 2:40 o las 3:20, left 20, de la mañana, in the morning, de la mañana. Uh-huh. Acá. ¿Qué hora es?
Es la una
de la tarde, ¿cierto? Es la una de la tarde. Okay. Okay. Interrogative word. ¿A dónde? ¿Cómo? This box is from your book. So this is on your book, and it's very useful. Because at the beginning, when I was learning English, I confused with where, what, how. No, like I go to the store and I say, "What cost? And instead of how much?" Or awful. The W questions and all that are very important. So, ¿a dónde? Where to? ¿Cómo? ¿Cuál? Or ¿cuáles? This is singular or plural. ¿Cuándo? ¿En cuánto? So, ¿cuándo? With V. ¿En cuánto? With T. Okay. ¿Cuántos? This is plural. Or ¿cuántas? So, the difference between ¿cuánto? And ¿cuántas? Is ¿cuánto? Is how much. But ¿cuántos? Is how many. So, it's different. Okay. Luego, ¿de dónde? ¿Dónde? And the other one was, ¿a dónde? The first one, ¿a dónde? ¿De dónde? ¿En dónde? ¿Por qué? ¿Qué? ¿Quién? ¿En quiénes? Okay? So, this box is very useful. Okay? It's in your book, too. And then you have the numbers, right? Remember that we did the small numbers first. These are not too difficult because once you learn 30, you just have to add 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and then 40, and the same thing. 41, 2, 3, 4. So you have to learn like the 10 first numbers mostly. And then you just add to the 40, 30, 50. 51, 52, it's like in English, okay? So this box is also from your book, okay? Okay, so with verbo ser, verbo ser y estar, verbo ser. Son las 5 de la tarde, the time. With verbo gustar. With verbo gustar. A mí no me gustan los gatos. That's not true. I like cats. I have a cat. Tengo una gata. Se llama Toñita. Okay. A mí no me gustan los gatos. And then conjugating verb. María camina. No caminas, es camina. María camina todos los días. Okay. So, verbo ser and estar. Remember the difference between them. Verbo ser always for telling time. El verbo gustar, we have a pronoun, right? And we conjugate the verb, María camina todos los días. We conjugate the AR verbs, okay? What else? Tenemos, okay, review. El verbo ser, yo soy, tú eres, él es, nosotros somos, vosotros sois, ellos son. When do we use verbo ser? For what things we use verbo ser?
Time.
Time? ¿Qué más?
Permanent.
Por ejemplo, un ejemplo. Describe yourself, for example. Tell me something about yourself using verbo ser.
Yo soy alto.
Yo soy alto. Okay. Verbo estar. Yo estoy, tú estás, él está, nosotros estamos, vosotros estáis, ellos están. Now, tell me something about yourself, but using verbo estar. When do we use verbo estar? For what? Give me an example.
When it can change, maybe. Mm-hmm. So I can say yo estoy muy bien, because I can be happy one moment and then sad another.
Mm-hmm. Yo estoy en mi casa. I'm at my house. Mm-hmm. Yo estoy comiendo. I'm eating. Okay. Yo soy alto en estoy feliz. Soy alto.
Yo soy en carro.
Mm-hmm. También yo estoy en el carro.
Estoy en la clase de español.
Yo estoy en la clase de español. Uses of ser, nacionalidad, profesión, característica de cosas y gente, generalizaciones, posesión, tiempo y fecha, right? And then uses of estar, location, health, physical state and conditions, emotional state. Estoy feliz, I'm happy, right? The weather, it's raining outside. Está lloviendo. Mm-hmm. Okay. Okay. In what part of your homework are you right now? Have you all complete your homework? In what part of the homework are you doing right now?
We completed the homework for the 21st, right? Well, not the 21st. Yeah, 21st. The ones that was on due on the 21st.
Uh-huh.
Was that two B's?
I took two tests.
I'm on Kinner and Spinner, I believe.
Okay, no, ya terminamos con esto. Okay, let me go to chapter. So we are on the university, right? Or the family? Family vocab or university vocab?
Yeah, we should be going into the family one.
Yay. Okay, yeah, we finished this. We finished the sense of Peru, Latam, Comunicación, attending time. Okay. I forgot the pages. So. It's hard when I used to meet with the class twice a week, so now it's just once. So I'm like confusing. Where am I?
I know it's past 50.
50, yeah, because this is La Universidad. We finished this one. Remember when we have classes like this? Like this, all the students in the classroom. Okay, so, no, it's 50, yeah, 50. Yes, so here you have the present tense of AR verbs, right? So this is what we did. And then you have the ER verbs and the IR verbs, okay, like this. So this is university, and these are the common verbs, the common AR verbs. You can take picture, like a screenshot of this, and it's like the same thing that I use for the PowerPoint. So the book, something good from the book, something nice that I can say from the book, is that it has nice information. Like the boxes, I'm telling you, that those are nice. Okay, so we did this, right, the common AR verbs. And then here you have the verb gustar, right? It's here. Me gustan, a mí no me gusta. So you have the pronouns right here and something to practice. And then, so this is more example. Okay, so you're done with this forming question in Spanish. We kind of did these two. And so this is the one I have on the PowerPoint. Yay! The interrogative words is on the page 56. 56. And the questions here, okay? And I want to get to the family part. Okay, present tense of verbo estar. We did the verbo estar. Prepositions to use with verbo estar. That's good. And numbers. We got the numbers too. And so that I'm not missing anything. And vocabulary and okay, so this is what you're gonna start doing now, right? This is the new homework. And let me see something. So aquí está. Okay, so we did this present tense of AR, present tense of estar. Okay, so next week is the week 6, right? We are on the week 6 already. Oh my God. Okay. La familia, do September 28th. Oh, my cat is crying, but it's so loud. Okay, so today is 23. So this is what you have to do for next week. Okay, oops. Chapter 6, week six, chapter three, La Familia, due date September 28th. These are your participation too. The participation that when you do the post, it has a lot of percentage on your grade, okay? So it's very important. The journal topic, I'm being very nice with your journal topics. I give you 100 always. The Lingua Meeting chat, I cannot do that much because I just copied the grade they gave you. The Lingua Meeting follow-up, I also give you 100 for that. Complete the activities. These are the activities that you have to do on DHL this week. This is your homework now. So you are going to do La Familia and vocab, describe adjectives, possessive adjectives, and the present tense of verb er and ir. Okay, so we already did the AR verbs. So in a few minutes, I can explain you these two, so your homework will be easier. Okay, so we are on here. Okay, so this is capítulo 3, La Familia. Okay, are you familiar with the vocabulary, the family vocab? La mamá, el papá, el hijo, la hija. No es tan difícil. Sí. El abuelo, la abuela, el sí. tío, la tía. So, you know, in español, we have the masculine and feminine for everything. El hijo, la hija. La mamá, el papá. La abuela, el abuelo. So you will have the article la or el, depending if it's feminine or masculine. And las mamás is feminine and plural. Los hijos es plural. El hijo es singular. Okay, so masculine, feminine, singular, and plural. Okay, it is very important. Okay, so you have a family tree here. El vocabulario is here. And I want you to teach you the important thing, the grammar. So then you're not struggling on your homework and your test, your lesson test. So, ¿dónde está? I want to show you the next. So, I'm a pharmacist. Okay. So, oh, do you know that if you do on, if you press this thing, tutorial, it explains you things, okay? It's a tutorial, so it's nice. En español, siempre, siempre, always. Masculine, feminine, singular, and plural. Siempre. You know already noun, the nouns, right? Like Juan, Pedro, la mamá. El verbo es verbo ser, to be. And then you add an adjective next to it. Como Javi es simpática. Juan es simpático. Javi es bonita. So this is what you're going to do. On this chapter is the family vocab. So it's like describe your family. Mi mamá es simpática. My mom is nice. My dad is tall. My brothers and sisters or my siblings are noisy. Are crazy. Okay? So describing your family, it will be for using the vocab and using the adjectives next to the noun and the verbo ser. Okay? You know that for describing people, we use verbo ser. So do not write, mi mamá está, no. Okay? Verbo ser and adjective. Okay? Nice, cute, bonito, simpático, inteligente, etcétera, etcétera. Okay? And remember that the verbo, the feminine and masculine, okay? So this is what they are gonna ask you to do, is to use what you have learned so far, the verbo ser, okay? And here, this box right here is very useful, okay? I recommend you to write it down and take a picture, because with this, you can write sentences. For example, alto, mi papá es alto, my dad is tall. Bonito, mi hermano, my brother es bonito. Malo, mi hermano es malo, he's bad. Pelirrojo, moreno, brunette, or pelirrojo, red hair, rubio, okay. Tomás, ¿tú eres rubio? ¿Sí? ¿Eres rubio? Tomás, ¿tú eres rubio?
Rubio.
Blondie.
Rubio, oh, sí.
Okay, because you have the hair.
Sí, and also pelirrojo.
Pelirrojo, la barba, that's barba.
Barba, sí.
Barba. Y eres trabajador, hardworking, eres trabajador.
¿Y me?
Sí.
Ah, sí, mucho.
Mucho, sí, mucho. Ok. Yo soy vieja. Yo soy vieja, soy old y soy morena. Soy morena y soy inteligente. Okay? So, ya saben. These are for describing. Probably they are gonna tell you on the journal topic or so, like describe your family. So there you go. Here you have some shortcut to write your journal. And I do this for nacionalidades. Yo soy chilena, from Chile, chilena. Mexicano, it's from Mexico. So you have the here, nacionalidades. Y, so what is that? So, sí, I told you. Mi hermano, my brother, es simpático. Mi esposo, my nephew, my parents. And then add the adjective next to the activity. Those are the activities that you're gonna have to do for your homework. And I wanna get to the, okay, these are the possessive adjectives. Why are we learning the possessive adjectives in this unit? Because you're gonna say my husband, mi esposo, my brother, your mom. So, mi esposo, tu mamá, mis hermanos, sus padres, okay, your parents, okay. So these possessive adjectives are for tell about your family members, but also you can use this for my car, my cell phone, my money, etc., my classes, etc. Okay, so everything that's possessive, but in this unit they use it for relationship purposes. Related to your family, okay? Okay, so this is all what it's coming. It's first time that we are like ahead of the book, from the book, finally. Okay, so here, for example, you tienes una actividad. La familia de Manolo, Manolo's family, okay? And, okay, so we need to read this and we have to, I want to make it bigger. Okay, this is page 94. So we read this and we choose between nuestro, mi, and sus. Nuestro is ours, mi is mine, sus, yours. Okay? And nuestra.
Repeat me, sus, yo.
Me is, yeah, mine. Mine. Sus is yours, nuestro, ours, okay? And then sus is su, mis is the plural form, su and sus is singular, plural. Nuestra, nuestro is singular, feminine, masculine. And you're going to find nuestros is the plural form of that. Remember, everything in Spanish has like five forms. Singular, plural, singular, feminine, singular, masculine, plural, feminine, and plural, masculine. Okay? Four. Okay? So, like here. Let me put it again. Where is it? Where was this? ¿Dónde estaba? Ya se me perdió el cuadrito. I lost it. Aquí está. Okay. So es la página 93. Okay. See on the page 93. Aquí está. So, like, in español, we got me and mis. In English, is my. So, in Spanish, you have the singular plural. Tú, tus. In English, is your familiar. So, in English, it's just one form. In Spanish, is two. Su and sus. You have his, her, its, and your. Okay? Nuestro and slash nuestra is masculine feminine. And nuestros and nuestras is masculine feminine plural. And English is our. Okay? So you have four forms. In English, one. Our in español is nuestro, nuestra, nuestros, nuestras. Same with vuestro, which is your familiar. And su singular, sus plural, their and your, okay? So, yeah, it's think on like in Spanish, everything it will be feminine or masculine and singular and plural, okay? So where was this activity that I here? Okay, so we have la familia de Manolo, Manolo's family, okay? So let's read someone from the class can read number one and we can choose between nuestro, mi, and sus. Who wants to read the first one?
Me llamo Manolo y mi hermano es Federico.
Muy bien. Me llamo Manolo y mi hermano, my brother, es Federico. Muy bien. La segunda. Who wants to read number two?
Miss Madra Silvia. As professor in Encina Quimica. Be my mother or
it doesn't say my mother, it says miss. It's like you have two mothers.
Sus
is also plural. Sus is also plural. So sus and mis in this sentence, sus and mis are plural. So it should be like mis madres or sus madres, and okay. It's not plural. So it has to be nuestra, our mother. So you're saying it works, our mother, because it's singular. Es una madre. So it's like you're talking on behalf of your brother, too. Oh, nuestra madre, our mom is nice. It's a teacher and she teaches chemistry, okay? But we cannot use sus or mis because the word madre es singular. And the word nuestra es singular. It doesn't say nuestras. It could say nuestras. The word nuestras exists. It's the plural form. But here is the singular. So it has to agree. Okay? So in the first one, me is singular, and the word hermano is also singular. Number two, nuestra es singular, and madre es singular. Okay? La número tres.
Ella admira a sus estudiantes porque trabajan mucho.
Ella admira a sus estudiantes porque trabajan mucho. Okay, ella admira a sus estudiantes. So the word tú es singular. So it doesn't work. Nuestro is also singular. Sus es plural. Sus es plural. And estudiantes es plural too. Okay, so sus estudiantes porque trabajan mucho. Número cuatro.
Yo estudio en la misma universidad, pero no tomo clase con mi madre.
Exacto. Yo estudio en la misma universidad, pero no tomo clases con mi madre. Okay. I cannot say nuestras, because nuestras es plural and madre es singular. En tus es plural and madre es singular. So the only option is me. Okay. Número cinco. Número cinco. Federico
trabaja y una asigna con nuestro padre.
Nuestro.
That's why I sent you.
Nuestro.
I don't know about you, but it's a whole lot easier.
Nuestro padre. Okay. Federico trabaja en una oficina con nuestro padre.
See if I'm finished with my Spanish class yet or not.
Oficina con mis padres, no. Okay. En una oficina con, okay. So it cannot be mis because it's plural and padre es singular. Okay. It could be either tú or nuestro. Grammatically, both could be. Yeah, but we need to think on the context of the conversation to choose between tú and nuestro. Okay. Okay, so Federico is his brother, so it's our father, okay? So it will be nuestro padre, that is correct. Okay, number six.
Mi oficina está en el centro de la Ciudad de México.
Mi oficina está en el centro de la... Okay. It could be mi oficina, it could be su oficina, or it could be tu oficina. All of them, grammatically, could be correct. But the context of the conversation, we are talking about Federico. Oh, someone has the
Lonnie,
your cell phone is, your microphone is on.
I kind of need to know what happened.
Thank you.
The last I heard, somebody.
Lonnie. Oh.
I'm trying to. And it sounds like, yeah. Okay. So, yeah, and number six, all of them could be me, su, tu, depending if we are talking about my office, his office, or your office. But the whole conversation we are following is Manolo is talking about his brother, Federico. So the whole time he refers to his brother, Federico. So it should be su oficina, his office. Okay, because he's saying, hi, my name is Manolo, and my brother, Federico, blah, 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 blah. Okay, so it's his office. Número siete, Javier y Oscar son tíos. Javier y Oscar, so it's plural. So it cannot be me, because that one is singular. So it could be Miss. Or Sus. Mis tíos de Oaxaca. ¿Y tú? ¿Cómo es?
Tu
familia. Because he's asking you. Okay. ¿Cómo es tu familia? Okay. So, yeah. These are kind of like the activities that you are going to do. Okay. And now we go to the part important. The present tense of air and ear. Okay. You have a tutorial here, remember? So the good news is that the air and ear is almost the same. The only difference will be in nosotros. Okay. So it's the same conjugation in the singular form in air and ear, but in the plural form, only on nosotros, and with the AR verb, it will be comemos, the ending it will be hemos, and for example, with escribir, the ending will be escribimos, okay? But the second one, vosotros, also kind of similar, but in the ER, it will have an E extra, so es E in the español, es E, E in English. And the last part is the same. So with the ER and IR verbs, with the ER and IR verbs, is the same conjugation on singular, okay? Singular, conjugación, okay? Pero en plural, it's almost the same. It would be only different in nosotros y vosotros. Es diferente, okay? Okay, so remember, en ER and IR en la parte singular es la misma, igual. En la parte plural, nosotros y vosotros, it will be different, okay? And the endings, I prefer that you do like the square that I did before. So with O-S-E, O-O-S-E. Hemos, es, en. And the other one will be similar. O, es, e, same. Hemos, is, en. Okay, los de endings. Okay, for the conjugations. Okay. So it's pretty much the same with the AR, but instead of taking out the AR part, you're going to take out the ER or the IR. And add the endings that we add for the AR, but now you have to add those endings right here. El O, E. Okay? ¿Se entiende? I know I give you too much information today. Mucha información. Pero, ¿sí está bien? ¿Sí entienden? ¿Sí? 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 ¿No?
Sí.
Okay. Okay. Yeah, so this week you have to work on your VHL, and it will be pretty much the last thing we did, the ER and AR verbs in family possessive adjectives and describing your family. Okay, and so the next class we can work on what is coming up again. We can do a review of the ER and IR verbs. And as we have the verbo gustar as the exception of the AR verbs, and the ER, we have the verbo tener, to have, is our big exception. So next class, I'm gonna focus on that, okay? That is important because you're gonna pass this class, but when you get to 1020, the verb tener and all this, it will be very important, okay? So next class, we are gonna focus on that, okay? See? And, okay.